Mr. Malika Elikavela, Managing Director, Evamo Corporation.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Good to see a lot of known faces. I'm Malika Elikavela, Managing Director of Evamo Corporation. We represent the integrated energy multinational, ENI and regional brand, Power Oil from APA Industries of India. I have been in the lubricant industry since 2000, having worked for local affiliates of Shell, ExxonMobil, and BP Castrol until 2014, and agency representation and local distributorship since then. I thought that it is very much in the interest of the audience to speak about rights of the lubricant consumer and factors affecting the decision making under the present market dynamics in the industry. We all know about the numbers of the industry as it's readily available with PUCSL. But what we don't know is the extent of the rights of the lubricant consumer and what factors affecting their decision making. I would like to get into the shoes of an average consumer and find answers for following questions. Where are we? There are multiple brands to choose, and in certain cases, only few are available at service stations and lube changing centers. I have been told to use 0W20 grade oil, and in certain cases, the service station guys have used 5W30 grade oil. They say it's fuel efficient, but we don't know how to check it. Also, they say to use the same vehicle make oil as it is recommended, but don't know whether it's the right choice. They also say of API and all kinds of standards, but we don't know the measure of standards. My car manufacturer recommends a specific brand of lubricant, but it is not available in Sri Lanka. I prefer to use in small cans, but they continue to use it from oil drums. Why are we there? We have been told to use it, and we have been using it. Service station guys recommend it, and I guess we trust them and go by their advice without any issues. Sometimes we check with car agent and go by their advice on the type of lubricant. Where do we want to be? We would like to know more about lubricants and difference of grades and what's suitable for our vehicles. How do we get there? We would like lubricant importers and connected authorities to create awareness and have continuous consumer-driven programs periodically. In order to address what is being mentioned, I would like to propose following answers in a form of suggestions. These are to be taken up at ministry and relevant authority levels. We believe that PUCSL should be elevated to a fully-fledged regulator from a shadow regulator position with muscle power. A consumer awareness committee to be implemented, comprised of all lubricant manufacturers, importers, and brand representatives to be chaired by PUCSL. A percentage of sales to be allocated by all lubricant brand license holders for the functions of above committee. Lubricant standards criteria to be amended as per most required vehicle categories such as combustion engines and hybrid engines, and put forward the minimum standards. It is high time that diesel engine oil market to be upgraded to multi-grade market with proper standards and awareness in line with OEMs and PUCSL to take initiatives on this. Import of specific products under special approvals needs to be further regulated and put under scrutiny, as we find importers of white oil are being misused in large scale in terms of backyard grease manufacturing by small timers. Fully synthetic and semi-synthetic classifications must be strictly monitored to curtail unscrupulous imports and imports made under the guise of spare parts. To curtail direct license imports of OEM engine oils, only to allow OEM endorsed ancillary products such as ATF to be imported as part of meeting the OEM warranty criteria. To encourage Finnish lubricant exports to upscale the local blending manufacturers to regional markets. A task force to be formed to further curtail the adulteration of mixing of lubricants with relevant law enforcement authorities. In conclusion, the fully liberalization tag on the lubricant market to materialize its real meaning, market needs to be opened up through a proper and a candid process for a few more global and regional brands to make way to the industry. We are one of the sidelined brand representatives during the abruptly halted our last RFQ process in 2014. It is also the right of the consumer to choose from a wide range of top-notch brands with new generation of OEM approvals. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.